Hello students, in the previous video we have learned about the dv ideal gas equation and the deviation of the gases from the ideal behavior. Now in this video we are going to learn the reason behind the deviations from the ideal behavior and the efforts made by the van der Waals to correct them. That means he proposed the equation in order to explain the real behavior of the gases. That equation is known as the van der Waals equation. Van der Waals equation of gas state. Van der Waals equation of states. Okay, na? So first of all, we go for the causes for the deviations from the ideal behavior. So, while proposing the ideal gas equation, actually ideal gas equation is proposed on the basis of the kinetic molecular theory, KMT. In KMT, two wrong assumptions were made. So first fault assumption is that the volume occupied by the gas molecule themselves is negligible as compared to the total volume of the gas. So here gas volume means nothing but the volume of the container in which that gas is kept. So generally the volume of the container itself is considered as the volume of the gas, and the actual volume of the all the gas molecules is considered as a negligible volume. This is true only at low pressures, because at low pressures the gas molecules are very far from away each other. So that's why the compared to the volume of the container, and that means volume of the gas, the actual volume occupied by the gas molecules is very less. So that's why this point is acceptable only at low pressures. But at high pressures, the molecular volume constitutes a significant fraction of the total volume and cannot be ignored. At high pressures, what happens? The gas molecules are brought together. So as a result, the volume of the gas decreases. As a result, what happens here? In that case, we have to consider the actual volume of the gas molecules also. Here, we have evidence for the actual volume of the gas molecule, that gases can be liquefied and solidified. So on applying high pressures and low temperatures, we can liquefy the gases into the solids, and again if we cool low temperatures and use high pressures, then that those liquids can be converted into the solids. But the solids cannot be compressed by using high pressures, and there we observe no decrease in the volume of the solids, because already they are very close to each other and the distances among the molecules in a solid, in the solids, are very less. So that's why the molecules come very close to each other, and here as the molecules have considerable volume, there will be no further decrease in the volume of the solids on applying the high pressures. So this is the strong evidence that molecules have the some considerable volume. So this is the wrong or faulty assumptions made during the derivation of the ideal gas equation. Okay, this is the first faulty assumption. And the second faulty assumption is that the molecules of gas exert no appreciable attraction upon each other. According to the kinetic molecular theory, there are no attractions or repulsions among the gas molecules. But it is not true. If it is so, then it is not possible for us to liquefy and to solidify the gases. On applying the high pressures and low temperatures, what happens? The gas molecules come close to each other and attract one another. As a result, what happens? They change into the liquids and into the solids. And one more evidence is that gases cool on expand. This is Joule-Thomson law. when we expand the gases, they cool, they become cool, because during expansion, the distances among the gas molecules increase. So here the thermal energy is consumed in order to overcome the internal attractions. For that purpose, the energy will be consumed. As a result, the temperature decreases. As a result, the gases cool. So cooling of gases on expansion is strong evidence that gas molecules have appreciable attractions among themselves. So these two wrong faulty assumptions were made during the derivation of the ideal gas equation. So that's why here we observe the deviations from the ideal behavior. Now we have derived ideal gas equation by using the gas laws, Boyle's law, Charles's law, and Avogadro's. Now that equation is PV is equal to the nRT. So this ideal gas equation holds good only at high pressures, high temperatures and low pressures. High temperatures and low pressures. We can remember this as HTLP. Hitech Lakshmipathi. Hitech Lakshmipathi. So like that we can easily remember. So gases show the ideal behavior only at high temperatures and low pressures. High temperature and low pressures. And at low temperatures and at high pressures, they don't show the ideal behavior. At low temperatures and at high pressures, they tend to convert into the liquids as well as into the solids. They lose their ideal behavior. Now, van der Waal made some corrections to this equation and proposed a new equation which is known as the van der Waal equation of states. And by using that equation, he was able to explain the deviations. So, for here he corrected the correction to the volume. Then after we go for the correction made to the pressure. At low pressures, ideal volume is equal to the real volume of the gas. That means the volume of the container. Here simple V. It is the volume of the container. So here ideal volume means the volume the space that is available for the gas molecules to move is known as here ideal volume. So here ideal volume is almost equal to the volume of the container, because compared to the volume of the container, the gas molecules are very small. As a result, here we can neglect their actual value. But at high pressures, what happens means the ideal volume decreases and it becomes less than the actual volume provided by the container. That means the volume of the gas. Here the volume of the container is called as the volume of the gas. So the ideal volume, that means the volume available for the free movement of the gas molecules. Here ideal volume means the volume available for the free movement of the molecules is less than the actual volume provided by the container. So here at high pressures we present ideal volume as the Vi is equal to the Vn minus Nb. Here Vi means ideal behavior, ideal volume. Here B means non-compressible volume or the volume of the gas molecules. B indicates the non-compressible volume, and it is also known as the co-volume, and N is the number of the moles. So this is the correction made by the van der Waal to the ideal volume. This is B is also known as the excluded volume or non-compressible volume or co-volume. Three names are there for the B. Okay. So this is the correction made by the van der Waal for the volume. Next we go for the correction made in the here we have to know the relation between the excluded or co-volume and the actual volume of the gas molecules. Here the number of molecules in one mole gas is equal to the n is known as Avogadro number. Any one mole gas contains Avogadro number of the molecules, that we know very well, that is 6.023 into 10 to the power of 23. And if the radius of one molecular sphere is r centimeters, then the volume of the one molecule may be calculated by the equation 4 by 3 into phi r cube. So this equation 4 by 3 phi r cube, 4 by 3 phi r cube is the equation used to calculate the volume of the sphere. So here, as the radius of the molecule sphere is r, then the equation becomes as 4 by 3 phi r cube. But it happens as the gas molecules are brought together. So as a result, what happens? These gas molecules touch one another, as shown in this picture. So here, in between these two molecules, no other molecule can come and sit. So here the circle shown with this green shows another sphere, that means in that provided area. So look, we can write another molecule like this. So assume that this one is the central molecule and it is surrounded by the other molecules like this. So here we can take the radius, all radii like this, and we may draw another big sphere like this. So this big sphere is known as the now effective sphere. So the volume of the effective sphere, is 2r. So and in this effective sphere, no other molecule can enter and sit. So the volume of the effective sphere can be calculated by the equation like this. So the effective volume or the excluded volume here is calculated by the equation 4 by 3 into pi into 2r cube. Otherwise it becomes as 8 into 4 by 3 phi r cube. So this is the excluded volume for the one molecule is so here 8 into 4 by 3 phi r cube is the excluded volume for the two molecules. So if you calculate the excluded value for the one molecule, that becomes is as 1 by 2 into 8 into 4 by 3 phi r cube. Otherwise it becomes as 4 into 4 by 3 phi r cube. So this is the excluded value for one molecule. But in one mole of gas, we have the n number of the molecules. So for one mole of the gas, the excluded volume is 4 into n into 4 by 3 phi r cube. And here 4 by 3 phi r cube is considered as the volume of one sphere. So volume of 4 spheres is n number of spheres is n into 4 by 3 phi r cube. That means the excluded volume for a molecule or for one mole of gas is 4 times than the actual volume of the molecules. So excluded, once again I am reading, the excluded volume or co-volume or non-compressible volume is 4 times than the actual volume of the gas molecules. So that we have to remember. Okay, no? Now we go for the correction made to the pressure. at low pressures, the molecules of an ideal gas do not exert any force of attraction on one another because they remain far away from each other. But when high pressures are used, the gas molecules come close to each other. As a result, at high pressures, what happens? The attractions among the gas molecules begin to operate. So now we see the situation here. Look here, in this picture we can see that at high pressures, the molecule here, the red color molecule, is attracted by the other molecules. Look here, color differentiation is shown in order to understand the concept. Look here. So the other molecules equally in all the directions. So this is the molecule at high pressures present in the bulk. So it is attract or inside the container. So it is away from the container, walls of the container. So here this molecule is attracted by the all the molecules in all the directions equally. So as a result, the net force acting on this middle molecule is zero. But the situation is somewhat different at the walls of the container. So here this red color molecule is near to the walls of the container. Here this molecule is attracted by the other molecules only in one side, but the other side gas molecules are not present. That means the molecule which are moving near to the wall of the container is somewhat experiencing somewhat inward pull. So if inward pull is not there, then red color gas molecule can hit the container with somewhat great force and it exerts some high pressure. It exerts some pressure. Due to this inward attractions or inward pull, this molecule is not able to hit the walls of the container according to its capacity. So that's why here the pressure exerted by this molecule decreases. So either this decreased pressure due to the attractions has to be added to the ideal pressure in order to explain the deviation. So here, yes, ideal pressure is PI. PI is the observed pressure or the PI means here ideal pressure. Ideal pressure means the pressure exerted by the gas if there are no attractions. So that is the ideal pressure. But in actual practice, what happens at high pressures? What happens? Some pressure decreases due to the attractions. So the decreased pressure has to be added to the observed pressure in order to get the ideal value. So here the equation for the ideal pressure becomes as Pi is equal to the capital P plus small p. Pi is the ideal pressure, ideal pressure, and P is the observed pressure, and small p is the correction term that has to be made for the pressure. So here this correction term small p related to the inward pull. So that is proportional to the number of molecules per unit volume of the gas. Inward pull is directly proportional to the number of molecules per unit volume of the gas, that is N by V. And the attractive force on one molecule, the attractive force on one molecule is proportional to the N by V. That means the concentration of the, otherwise the number of the molecule that are attracting, that are pulling the molecule into the container. So here N by V can be considered as the concentration. So if more number of molecules pull the molecule into the container, then we observe more decrease in the pressure. So the decrease in the pressure depends on the number of molecules that are attracting the red color molecules. So attractive force, so we can say that attractive forces on one molecule is proportional to the n by v. In the similar way, if more number of molecules, if the molecules that are going close to the container increases, if the more number of molecules are present at the container, we observe more decrease in the pressure. So decrease in the pressure is observed when this number of molecules that hit the container increases. In the similar way, that we observe decrease in the pressure when the number of molecules, attracting this molecule increases. So in the both these cases, we observe decrease in the pressure. So now the total number of the molecules striking per unit area of the wall is proportional to the number of molecules per unit volume gas molecules. So here also it is proportional to the n by v. So n by v into the n by v. So this, so now so look here, my dears. So inward pull depends on the number of molecules that hit the walls as well as the number of molecules that attract those molecules which hit the walls of the container. So as a result, the correction term P is proportional to the attractive force of attractive force on one molecule as well as the attractive force on one molecule per unit area of the wall. So both are to be considered. As a result, it becomes P is proportional to the n by v into n by v is equal to the capital N square capital N by v all to the power of 2. But we know very well that the number of molecules is proportional to the number of moles. That means capital N is proportional to the small n. Capital N indicates the number of the molecules and small n indicates the number of moles. So if the number of moles increases, number of molecules also increases. So as a result, we can replace capital N with small n. Now the correction term becomes as proportional to the small p is proportional to the small n by v all to the power of 2. If we remove the proportionality, we have to put one constant, that is p is equal to the a n x square by v x square. So this is the correction made to the pressure, So in the place of the ideal gas equation, that is PV is equal to nRT, if we substitute the corrected ideal volume and ideal pressure, we get P plus AN x square by V square into V minus NV is equal to the nRT. This is for the n moles of the gas. And for 1 mole of the gas, it becomes as P plus A by V square into V minus V is equal to the RT. This is for 1 mole of the gas. A and B are known as the van der Waals constants. Now we go for the units of the van der Waals constants. Here, first of all, we go for the units of A. Here, A n x square by v x square term is nothing but pressure only. So, if on rewriting those terms, we get this one. A is equal to the p v x square upon n square. P is pressure, v is value, and m is moles, number of moles. So the units of A are atmosphere into liter square into mole to the power of minus 2. Now we go for the units of B. Here V minus NB is equal to, so B is nothing but volume term. So from the V minus NB we can get V is equal to the V by N. So here V means volume and N means number of moles. So the now the units for the B become as liter into mole to the power of minus 1 or liter per mole, So these are the units for A and B. This A and B depend on the nature of the gas. As the A and B values increase, the tendency of any gas to change into liquid also increases. So as the easily liquefiable, easily liquefiable gases have high AB values, high AB values. Now, by using the van der Waals equation, that is B plus ANX square by V square into V minus NB is equal to NRT, we can explain. Otherwise, van der Waals was able to explain the deviations very well. So, how it explains, let us look. At high pressures, when the pressure is, in first case, when the pressure is not too high, so when the pressure is less or at low pressures, what happens, the volume of the gas is very high. So as a result, compared to the volume of the gas, the excluded volume or covolume becomes negligible. So under this case, what happens, V becomes very very greater than the small b. As a result, the van der Waals equation can be rewritten as the P plus A by V square into V minus, we can neglect this B. So as a result, the van der Waals equation becomes as P plus A by V square into V is equal to RT. And on removing the bracket, we get PV plus A by V is equal to RT. So if you take this AV onto this side, what happens? PV is equal to the RT minus AV. Here, RT is the ideal, RT represents the ideal behavior, and PV represents the actual value. So here, from the ideal behavior, we have to remove something. That means here we get some negative deviation. So look here, in this graph we can observe that one. So at low pressures we observe the negative deviations. At low pressures we observe the negative deviations. And when the pressure is too high, at high pressures, what happens? The volume decreases. As a result, compared to these high pressures, the A by V term becomes negligible. X square by V square term becomes negligible. Here we have write the X square terms. So these terms becomes negligible. As a result, we can remove from the pressure term. So as a result, the van der Waals equation reduces to the P into V minus B is equal to the RT. On rewriting the equation becomes as PV is equal to the RT plus PB. RT represents the ideal behavior. PV represents the actual behavior. So here, to get the actual behavior, we have to add something to the ideal behavior. So here we get the positive deviation. So in order to explain the actual behavior, we have to add something to the ideal behavior. So that is the case here we are observing in the graphs. So at high pressures we observe the positive deviations. And the third case, when the temperature is too high, then what happens? At high temperatures, gas expands. As a result, volume increases. So compared to these high volumes, the B becomes negligible. In the similar way, the A by V square, here we have tried V square, A by V square. So the A by V square also becomes negligible. As a result, we can remove A by V square as well as the B from the van der Waals equation. So as a result, what happens? Van der Waals equation reduces to the ideal gas equation, that is PV is equal to RT. So at high temperatures, we get this one, ideal behavior. Thank you. So the ideal gas equation is PV is equal to RT for 1 mole gas, and for n mole gas, ideal gas equation is PV is equal to RT, and van der Waals equation for van der Waals equation of states for n moles is b plus a by b plus a n x square by v x square into the v minus nv is equal to the nRT. This is for n moles of gas, and for one mole of gas it becomes p plus a by v square into v minus b is equal to the RT. So we have to remember these questions, because these are asked generally in the competitive exams.